Welcome to Oracle NetSuite version 2018, Release 1. The 2018.1 release has a number of features of interest to manufacturers. This video will touch on a few of those you might be interested in. Be sure to review the 2018.1 release notes for a full list of upcoming features and to find out more details on the benefits they can provide. The products you manufacture have to be sold, so let's start with some highlights in commerce. We're excited to announce the general availability of Suite Commerce Standard. Suite Commerce Standard is the entry point product into the Suite Commerce family of e-commerce products. Suite Commerce Standard and Suite Commerce Advanced are built from the same code base and have the same features. Suite Commerce Standard combines the simplicity and ease of Site Builder along with the sophistication of Suite Commerce Advanced, providing users easy-to-use tools to build and manage a feature-rich e-commerce site, attracting traffic and increasing revenue. Your Suite Commerce Standard website will be automatically updated with every release. No need of manual upgrades to the next version. Suite Commerce Standard seamlessly unifies e-commerce with your core NetSuite operational systems, inventory and order management, marketing, customer support, and financials, providing a single view of customer, orders, inventory, and other critical business data that delivers personalized and relevant omnichannel experiences. Employees drive your manufacturing company, so let's take a look at some of the highlights in human capital management. Access control is one of the foundational elements of effective HR software systems. HR systems must ensure that personal information, sensitive HR data, and confidential employee information is appropriately restricted. The new HCM permissions feature allows companies to safely permit access to employee data without disclosing sensitive or confidential information to those who shouldn't see it. These new permissions allow users to view other employees while restricting what data they see based on their relationship to that employee. There are three new permissions to facilitate controlled access of employee data. The employee public permission enables viewing anyone's employee record. The employee confidential permission enables viewing confidential job information direct reports. And the employee administration permission enables HR practitioners to view HR data for employees in their area of responsibility, but with access to only a limited set of information. When it comes to accessing employee data, users are not required to switch roles to act as an employee, a manager, or an HR representative. At the heart of manufacturing is supply chain management. We'll spend the rest of our time looking at some of the highlights that come with 2018.1. Over the past 18 months, NetSuite has been working with customers to understand better how they run and monitor their complex supply chains as part of the Supply Chain Operational Excellence, SCOPE, initiative. We have delivered many of the requested features, including advanced BOM, inbound shipment management, and quality management. In the 18.1 release, we are pleased to deliver the first phase of one of the most highly requested features, the Supply Chain Control Tower. In this release, we're delivering a global time phase view that summarizes your current and future inventory position across your entire global supply chain. This feature provides the ability to see inventory, demand and supply across a time horizon, and throughout the supply chain in a way that makes it easy to know when and where demand is beginning to outpace or fall behind plan. Supply is beginning to outpace or fall behind demand. Inventory is growing beyond or falling below planned levels. In a complex supply chain product, inventory investment can be significant. Having the right product at the right place to provide excellent customer service is paramount to having successful regional or global business. Having too much inventory ties up cash and can result in significant losses when products phase out. Having too little inventory can result in loss of sales and customer dissatisfaction if the product is not available when a customer wants it, or is too far away for a customer to receive it when they need it. This new supply chain snapshot feature will allow users to see demand orders, supply orders, and the running inventory balance through time across all subsidiaries and locations in a single snapshot. They'll be able to set up custom filters to see only the data they want to see, and be able to export data using the saved search that generates the snapshot data, in addition to being able to drill down into the transaction where required. One of the primary goals of the SCOPE initiative is to enable operational excellence by allowing the system to be configured to make all of the associated back-end financial transactions happen automatically, thereby allowing you to make the best use of your global inventory assets. Starting in the 2018-1, sales managers and sales reps now have the flexibility to enter a sales order that can be fulfilled from warehouses across all compatible subsidiaries. From an accounting perspective, this new cross-sub fulfillment reduces the number of steps to process intercompany fulfillment, receipt, and return transactions. For those customers using the Advanced Order Management feature to automatically assign the best fulfillment location to satisfy your determined service level, it will now support fulfillment automation across subsidiaries. Prior to this release, it was not possible to enter a shipping location on a sales order line that was not in the same subsidiary as the customer. Users had to create an intercompany transfer order or intercompany POSO to financially move the inventory from the sourcing subsidiary to the selling subsidiary. With the release of the cross-subsidiary fulfillment feature, users can enter the source subsidiary location on the sales order line and eliminate the need for intercompany transfer order or intercompany POSO. This feature allows customers to centralize their order entry process and support sales across their entire company, streamlines the order entry process, and identify the source location upfront in the order processing cycle, reduces the entry and maintenance overhead associated with intercompany inventory transaction processing, allows warehouses to ship product directly against the sales order rather than process a drop shipment order, provides better control of which subsidiaries and locations can interact with each other for product sourcing. In the 2018-1 release, we're adding a new feature, Inventory Status, that adds the ability to mark physical inventory with an attribute in order to drive internal processes, for example, quality control, picking, or item commitment. With the release of Inventory Status, customers will have the ability to represent the current state of usable inventory within a location. Statuses are user-defined and can explicitly state whether items in that state are sellable, adding the ability to control which types of items are shipped to the customers. This new feature is also available in the NetSuite WMS module. Companies who buy large quantities of product overseas for import were excited by the release of our inbound shipment management feature in the last release. This feature has been significantly enhanced with controls for how landed costs are entered and calculated. Landed costs refer to any ancillary costs that are incurred during transit and need to be applied to some or all of the items in the container. Typical examples include brokerage fees, duties, taxes, shipping costs, and so on. In the 2018-1 version of NetSuite, users will be able to enter landed costs at the inbound shipment or container level rather than item receipt level. Enter those costs in multiple currencies. Define which items on the shipment the landed costs should be allocated to. Choose between various landed cost allocation methods by value, by quantity, and by weight. See unit landed cost as well as total landed unit cost, landed cost plus purchase price for each item on the shipment. For those customers who have more complicated situations, SuiteScript is able to record, modify, and calculate landed cost on the inbound shipment record. Before the 2018-1 release, customers could only track landed cost on the item receipt. This new feature will provide much greater flexibility, increase the accuracy of your total inventory valuation, and significantly reduce the time it takes to track these additional costs. NetSuite introduced the Advanced Bill of Materials, BOM, functionality in the 2017.2 release to meet the needs of companies who might have more complex BOM structures and/or require the ability to support location-specific BOMs. We are pleased to announce several key enhancements with the latest release. 2018.1 offers the ability to customize the list of components on the Bill of Materials and Revisions record. If there is unique information that you need to track on the BOM, you can easily add the new fields. With the exposure of Bill of Materials and Bill of Materials Revision to Web Services, you can now integrate with other PLM and QMS systems. For improved usability, customers can now link BOMs and assemblies from the Bill of Materials record itself, thus simplifying the process of creating and managing new BOMs as they are developed. For customers using NetSuite's routing feature, you can have these automatically copied when you copy the bill of material, saving time and ensuring accuracy. Finally, NetSuite will now automatically set the effectivity end dates on previous revisions when creating a new one. As of the 2018.1 release, WMS Lite will be rebranded as NetSuite WMS to reflect its importance as the only native NetSuite WMS solution going forward. We've made several improvements to the user experience over the last year, culminating in a new icon-driven menu that can be easily understood by new users. As NetSuite functionality continues to evolve, NetSuite WMS is being updated accordingly with several new features supported. Cycle count plans can be reused to speed up count generation process. Enhancements to the replenishment and picking processes will ensure optimal inventory positioning and will help streamline mobile order picking. You can now also enter quantities in any relatable units of measure, UOM, directly through the handheld device, especially useful for those who keep inventory in multiple UOMs. And we are including support for the new inventory status feature so companies can more accurately commit to and fulfill orders. There are many new and improved features in 2018 Release 1, and these were just the highlights. To learn more about the new features we've covered and the many that we didn't have time for, please visit your new release portlet and read the release notes. It's also a great idea to make sure you have access to your preview account when it's made available to you. This is a great way to see hands-on how the new features will work with your own data. It's a free part of the service you get as a NetSuite customer, and we really encourage you to take advantage of your release preview access period. Thank you, and enjoy this amazing new release from NetSuite.